everything starts here in the composite room. Here we got all the molds from the SUX, and I cleaned up the main fuselage mold already. This is the main fuselage lower mold with all informations of the hatches, all positions of the hatches. For instance, this is the gear door. This is the SC compartment lower hatch. These molds are already cleaned and ready for waxing. So this is our release wax. This is a liquid wax. I filled it up in this spray bottle, so it is easier to apply it on the mold. And let's see how it works. So when the surface is covered mostly with wax, we take this small cloth and spread the wax all over, that we have a nice and shiny waxed surface. And with this liquid wax, we can work quietly fast and have a good result. So here we got the wax in a tin, and here we got the brush. And for small edges, it makes also sense to apply the wax with a brush to make sure it is exactly in this edge, like this, and there will be a very good release from the part afterwards. That's how I do it. Right after a few minutes, it looks like this. That means the wax is dried and the surface can be polished. For polishing, I use this very soft tissue. This is doing a quite good job. And don't press too hard, just a little bit. You don't want to remove the wax, just polish the surface that it is nice and shiny. And this is what we do with all this mold now. So, now about 4 hours are gone, and the wax is hardened and is polished and everything looks nice and shiny. And the next step is to apply the second release agent, that is the PVA. This is this blue liquid agent, and PVA means polyvinyl alcohol. And this is a very powerful release agent, and the importance on this step is to apply it in a constant thin film. For that, we use this special sponge. Yeah, the sponge I will fill in the next step with this PVA and show you how to apply this all over the mold surface. The PVA sponge I put into this glass that it can't dry out, and now it's still wet. And this time you don't have to shake this bottle before you use it. There is no reason for it. Put a little bit of this PVA onto the sponge, and here you can see how it is sucked in. Yeah, this looks really nice. Yeah, so that's quite enough, and now we can start to apply this film on our mold. Before working with the sponge, I apply the PVA with a brush on all axes, like I showed you before I done with the wax. This is very important to be absolutely sure that there is this PVA release agent in these hard edges. This is a very normal brush, and now we can start with our sponge. And now it's important to make sure that you reach every area. So I start here on the wing and make line by line. The lines are overlapping,
Take your time on this drop, that you reach every spot. And when the flat surface is already done, you go to the vertical surfaces, like this front wall.
Here we are in the composite stock. Here are all the materials, like the carbon fibers, glass fibers, and aramid fibers. And at first you want to start to cut this honeycomb. This is 2 millimeter honeycomb, and I already put some shablon on it. This is the upper fuselage shablon, and here is the wing shablon. And I like to show you now how to cut this honeycomb. For cutting the honeycomb, I use this electric cutter, very normal one, and I put the shablon on the honeycomb and also put some weights on it to keep it in position while cutting around. Here we are with the next part of the honeycomb. So right after cutting the honeycombs, it's time to cut the fiberglass. And here we got a component of fiberglass. This is the inner layer, and this one is made of altogether 4 layers. At the outside we see the 25 gram fiberglass, then there is a peel off fabric, a release fabric, and at the end we got a blanket for sucking in the resin and also give a good vacuum all over the surface. And there is our shablon, and let's cut. So now it's time to put some paint on the molds, but before doing this, I got here these shablons. This is to save the outer area of the mold from paint, because when here would be some paint, that would give problems while the vacuum process, especially the sealing. Yeah, paint and sealing doesn't work so good. And even if I would put some tape on here, when I release the tape, I would also release the PVA, and the release effect is gone. So a good idea is to make these composite shablons and fix them with these small clamps. Just bring it in its perfect position, put the clamps on it. And now it's ready for the paint job. So now all the parts are cutted, the honeycomb and even the outer glass fibers.
And in the next step, we can start with the laminating process. There's a lot of more material needed, especially the first layer is just these 25 gram per square meter glass fiber, and this we want to grab now in the store. So here we are back in the storage again, and up here we have the fibers. This is the vertical stabilizer and this is the wing. These are the two parts we want to build in the next video. And with this 25 gram glass fiber, this is not easy to handle because of the electrostatic and so on. And that's why I put these fibers down in the plastic film, like here, and roll it on. And then it is easy to grab one. This is really very, very fine material. And yeah, and this is how it goes. And now we grab four of them and even four of them. And bring it to the composite room. So here we are back in the composite room, and you see on the table is full of molds. These are the wing molds, and behind me we got the vertical stabilizer molds, and we also got additional material that is needed, for instance these carbon rovings and a lot of more reinforcement glass fibers and Kevlar fibers and rovings, and absolutely important, the laminating plan. For instance, this is for the wing. So that's it for the first part of the building process of the SUX, and in the next part I will show you all the materials, the resins, the tools that are needed to do it, and we will build the wings and even the vertical stabilizers. So have a great day and see ya in the next video. Bye bye.